Today's tech tip is about toxicity. I have Maria with Andersen Sterilizers with me to kind of help debunk some of those myths about EO gas. So when I work in practices that have these sterilizers, there's a lot of fear around the chemical itself or just operating the sterilizer in general. What kind of things can you tell me about EO gas that might compare to other things used in practices?
Those are great questions, and there are really two things that I'd like to relay to everyone, is that all chemicals used in a veterinary practice for sterilization have a level of toxicity. And ethylene oxide actually compares very closely with these other methods, and they are similar as far as exposure levels that are set in place by OSHA, or these other chemicals are worse. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to pick your brain as the expert. What are some of the name brand chemicals that you see in the veterinary practices?
For instrument use, I would say probably like Chlorhex, Novasan, those would be in like cold soaking type methods, as well as Cydex I've used with endoscopes, and mm-hmm. that's a very, I know, high toxicity type of chemical where I had to wear a lot of PPE for it. Just cage cleaners and things like that that would be used in the practice.
Yep, those are all great references. And one thing that I recommend to everyone who is using these types of chemicals is not to take my word for it. All of these chemicals should have a safety data sheet. Do your research. If you want to know what the exposure levels are or the toxicity levels are, do the research. Call your distributor rep. Ask for an SDS sheet. They should be able to give those to you without any hesitation. So one other point that I love to make is that ethylene oxide has a very long history. And we also know how to monitor for any type of exposure to ethylene oxide. So I have another question for you, Jacklyn. Have you ever monitored for exposure while using some of these other chemicals?
No, I haven't had any kind of monitoring for any kind of sterile processing.
That's, like I said, another good thing about ethylene oxide is the history. We have the monitoring badges. We have the personal badge that can be worn on the lapel. Jacklyn did a great video on this one, the AN94. So we've got your short-term exposure limit, or your 15-minute. We also have an 8-hour badge that can be hooked to a space near your work zone. So next time you have a chemical sterilant, cold soak, Cydex, bleach, think about if there's any monitoring for exposure when you're using those. I think you'd be surprised at what the answer is.
And I think also a good point is the difference between disinfection and sterilization, that EO gas is achieving a level of sterilization outside of like Cydex or Chlorhex is only disinfection. That's it for today's tech tips. Thanks, Maria.
You're welcome.
Contact your rep if you have any questions.